We don't know much about him to start with, but it is a long book. So you do come to know him, I hope, very well by the end. He is what is called a denied access area spy. These are real men and women who go into the most dangerous places in the world. They would go into Iran, into North Korea, into the very prohibited parts of Russia. So they are very brave people. They tend to work alone. They have the support of the intelligence community behind them. But finally, when you cross the border, you're by yourself. And there is no Geneva Convention of War to protect you. There will be no Red Cross packages coming. Basically, what waits for you is death if you get caught. And that was the start of the character. And he goes on quite an adventure. I think you have to mix the genres. I think it's very, very difficult to write just in one genre anymore, because narrative storytelling has changed so much in the written form. Funnily enough, I think it's been changed not by books, but by streaming things on television and by movies. Movies are way more bold in their narrative storytelling than they ever used to be. That is because the audience is growing in its sophistication about what it expects from stories. So in books like both Pilgrim and Locus, it's not enough just to do a spy story. It does have to be thrilling. I like to think of them more as adventure stories, big sweeping adventure stories. But yes, their main characters are spies, so they work within that genre. But you have to keep it alive. You have to keep changing. You have to try to reinvent the genre, because if you don't do that, you're just doing what everybody else has done. As far as the influences on me from journalism and movies and that, yes, I can't separate myself from my earlier careers. And in both of the novels, but in both Pilgrim and The Year of the Locust, they deal with very current events. Well, that's because I'm a voracious newspaper reader, a magazine reader, because that was my life for many years. I worked in newspapers, I worked in radio, I worked in current affairs. So I've always had a passionate interest in that, and that's continued. As far as screenwriting is concerned, it teaches you a lot. It teaches you to be very economical, very precise in what you do, and to tell a story just as well as you can. So all of those things combined when I decided to become a novelist. So yes, it's been, in many ways, I've been formed as a novelist by all of those earlier experiences. After Pilgrim came out, my youngest son asked me if I'd been a spy. So, of course, I told him I had been. And for the next week, he had a great deal of respect for me. And then finally, he said to me, "You weren't a spy. You're just BSing me." And I said, "Well, yeah, that's true." So he lost all respect. No, I have never been a spy, but I have talked to a lot of people who work within the intelligence community, and I've read a lot about it. And having been a journalist in America when I was very young, I did encounter quite a few people who worked at a high level in American intelligence. So that's all been very useful to me. If you leave Pearl Harbor out of it in the Second World War, America had never been attacked. And that's a huge difference between the American attitude towards war and aggression and that in Europe. It's pretty hard to find people in Poland or the Czech Republic or here in France where people are sort of cavalier about war, because it is still within memory of what happened from 1939 to 1945. That had never happened to America. Of course, it had the American Civil War, a very different experience. There was Americans fighting Americans. 9/11 comes along, And suddenly, that great bastion of defense was broken. Somebody sitting overseas could launch a devastating attack on America. That was a shocking thing. I was in America when that happened. My wife is American. And that was a sea change. And it launched the real age of terror. And in my view, and it mentions it in Locus, it launched the age of panic. People panic now about just about anything. I mean, the CIA are announcing, or not announcing, but are saying this week that there is going to be a very serious Iranian attack in revenge for what has happened in Gaza. Now, nobody knows whether that's going to be directed against Israel or against America. And so people in America that I talk to are very anxious. That wasn't true during the Eisenhower era. It wasn't true during, you know, I don't know, Jimmy Carter. It wasn't true during Ronald Reagan. But it's true now. I'm writing Pilgrim 2. I'm writing the sequel to Pilgrim as we speak. I'm not allowed to speak to talk too much about it because it is actually a really good idea. And you never know what people might do with it. But it is not chasing a terrorist. I am sick of terrorists. I had a terrorist in Pilgrim. I've got a terrorist in the Year of the Locust. I am done with terrorists. So Pilgrim 2 goes into a... He is, of course, still a spy, and he still is closely aligned with a very secret US intelligence agency called the Division. He comes out of retirement to track a very, very clever man who is doing something very bad. But that man is not a terrorist. It's a different landscape of adventure. Thank God.